Hi everyone. In this video, we will consider the remainder of the bit instructions. First, a look at the latch instructions. The latch coil acts differently from the normal and inverse coil. If the coil variable bit state is initially false and it is changed to true when the run condition is true, it will remain true even when the run condition has changed to false. The unlatched coil will be required to change the state of the variable bit back to false. Let us demonstrate the operation of these instructions. Drag a normally opened contact into the room. Drag a data source of S.1 to the contact. Also, drag a latched coil into the room with variable bit R.1. Then add a new room by clicking on this plus button. Drag a normally opened contact into it with variable S.2 and an unlatched coil with variable bit R.1. Same as the latched coil. In simulation mode, right-click on the S.1 button to toggle it. Observe that the R.1 output bit is now orange, the latched coil is green, and the unlatched coil is bright red, indicating a truth state. Now, right-click on S.2 button and observe that the output bit R.1 reverts to its initial false state. Using the same circuit setup from the last video, check that Nano V5 is selected as the hardware from the settings menu, and upload the code to the PLC. When the push button switches connected to input S.1 and S.2 are pressed one after the other, the indicator lamp connected to output R.1 is turned on and off. This can also be viewed with the live data window. The last two output bit instructions, flip on rising and flip on falling, changes the output variable bit state on either a rising signal edge or a falling edge respectively. To demonstrate the operation of the flip on rising instruction, right-click on the second row and delete it. Right-click on the latched coil R.1 and select turn into FOR. Upload the code into the PLC. Press the push button switch and observe that the indicator lamp is turned on. Press the switch again and observe that the lamp is turned off. The flip on falling instruction acts similarly to the flip on rising instruction. The one-shot instruction, when used with contacts, can momentarily change the output condition of a room, either on a rising edge or a falling edge. This will be shown later with mathematical instructions. In the next video, we will create a control program for the water pump in the simulation window. Thanks for watching. Click on the like button and share your thoughts in the comment section if you enjoyed this video. Hit the subscribe button if you are yet to, and the bell next to it. See you in the next video.